All right, so hello and welcome to my Secret Santa gift for ff6hacking.com. And I figure that my recipient, Gene Attack, probably already knows it's him because, I mean, seriously, this title screen here probably just gives it away. And I don't think it would make sense to give a video of Return of the Dark Sorcerer to anyone else. So, yeah. So, it might not be quite as obvious, though, what my gift actually is, and I figure that I'm going to do a blindfolded run of the first sections of the game. I'm not going to do the whole thing, obviously, because it took long enough to do Brave New World, and that's a lot easier and doesn't have as much extra content. Wow, I have to turn this down. I can't hear myself talk. So, yeah, I think I'm just gonna do the opening segments through Narsh here until I get to the overworld, and I think that's where I'll stop. And I'll just shove it all into one video regardless of how much that makes sense. So I'm hoping my brother can't hear me right now because I'm talking pretty loud and it's hard to modulate my voice properly when I can't. When I've got my headphones on. I'm not used to talking with my headphones on, so I'm probably shouting really loud, but yeah, my brother's technically on the Secret Santa list as well, so he's not supposed to know that I don't have him, but I guess it's not the biggest deal in the world if he finds out early, considering he's not my recipient. So I guess I'm not sure how much longer this cutscene is. It's not part of the standard game, so I've got no intuition for it. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7. Yeah, I waited way longer than was necessary there. Insane, because of course. And I mean, as much as I like this opening cutscene, I like it a lot more when I can see it, so let's just skip it. So, I hear much more dark and ominous music than the original game had, and that's saying something because the original game's music here was kind of dark and ominous as well. I think this is slightly longer than it was before, but it's hard to tell because I've got no musical guide to guide me here. So we get same sort of thing, panning over some different areas, but seems like a lot more activity going on. Well, I guess there was a scene of Narsh in vanilla, so there were some NPCs in the opening cutscene. And there was, of course, Kefka walking along at the one point, just kind of. You just kind of get a hint that he's there. Again, hard to. I don't really have a feel for how long this is going to last. With the original game, that's the one. Even Brave New World, that's one thing I always had going for me is that I've played the game quite a few times, so I generally know how long everything is. But with this game, things have changed a bit, so I'm really hoping I don't end up being sloppy because of my controller. Because my muscle memory is a little bit weaker with the SNES controller, because I never used it for any blindfolded playing before. I only used my Xbox controller, and that controller is not the one I'm using right now. Maybe I should have almost just plugged that one in instead, because I've still got it. It still works. I mean, maybe it would have been helpful to do that, but I guess I'm kind of stuck with it now. If I unplug and replug controllers while ZSNES is running, the controller doesn't get picked up again, so. And before you yell at me, "Oh, use S9X," it does the same thing, so. Okay, we have the final countdown, which is it's kind of funny because I've also heard this song, a rendition of the song for Super Mario World. So yeah, this feels weird because the X and B button that I'm alternating between, like I did so much during the original blindfolded playthroughs, they're a little bit farther apart now, so it just feels like ugh. Feels like something's wrong. Oh wait, I still got a mashup text. So they change. You guys changed some of the menu noises, so now they're really hard to hear, actually, when I press the B button. It's just this quiet, feathery sound that I can't. That's hard to notice if I'm talking. So go to config. I'm gonna adjust this to 6. Battle speed actually works in Return of the Dark Sorcerer. For those of you who know that it doesn't work in vanilla, it doesn't work properly, or at least in a reasonably sensible way in vanilla. And I'll adjust this to 1 because that's just annoying. It's at 6 right now to give me more time to react. As I recall in other versions of Return of the Dark Sorcerer, battle speed 1 was actually the best because it sped up all the gauges but didn't change any of the enemy's battle timers, which meant that enemy timed attacks that were often more powerful went off less often if you were on battle speed 1. But I think that Hatson's even gauge patch fixes with that or something. I'm not 100% sure. 1, 2, 3, 4 memory. And the weird thing is, it doesn't save my cursor yet, so I'm back up to item. I double-check that, because that's a weird idiosyncrasy that I've got to be aware of. Alright, I think that's it for that. And you might notice that for people who watched my original series, that I didn't set any of the controller slots to anything, and that's because that doesn't do anything. It doesn't give a different noise to player 1 and player 2 anymore, which I suppose is probably because of the even gauge patch that from Hatson. So, I guess that was dumped, the different noises. I can't see any other reason why that would be dumped, but maybe it's just something random. But that'll of course make this a lot harder, especially since Biggs and Wedge are literally clones of each other now, so I can't tell them apart. Isn't that fun? But I don't need to tell anyone apart for this battle. Whoa, that was weird. Oops. Yeah, that one attack sounded like it was both on the left and right sides. But yeah, for this, just blow him away with my Poison Storm and Air Rods. These are the best options for going through this area, to be honest. Oh yeah, and the battle music just keeps going, which doesn't really affect me because, or at least not right now, because it's still using the regular music outside the battles, so I can still tell when the battle ends. Not that it's crucial here. So yeah, just same strategy here. These guys are weak to fire, but it's not worthwhile to bother. Not when I can hit multi-target, and I know this is a one-hit KO on them all, so on them both, rather. So goodbye, dogs. And I don't mean that figuratively, I mean that literally. Takes all 3 this time around. 2 Bile Blasts isn't going to cut it. Hello. 2 Bile Blasts will cut it here because they're weak to it. See, that's so weird. It comes from the right, and then it also sounds like it hits the left. I have no idea what's up with that. I didn't notice that until just now, to be honest. Goodbye, dogs, and I mean that figuratively, not literally this time. So, after that, everyone gains a level. So, Aurora is level 4, and the soldiers have leveled up twice to 3. So yeah, double check. No use in wasting items at this stage. Most people seem to delve into the items right now, but skills, Aurora... Already messing up the skills menu. Magic here. Yeah, the skills menu is probably the one that gave me the most trouble during my other blindfolded runs. So, we've got another battle. Now this one I have to play more carefully, because these guys can actually do some damage, and I can't tell my characters apart very easily, which kinda sucks. Aurora especially takes a lot. Okay, so this is item menu. So I want you to use Poison Storm on the left. Whoops. You should also be using Poison Storm on the left. Just take out the one guard first off, first priority. And you keep yourself alive because you've got the lowest HP and lowest defenses. So you might actually be in danger, the other two probably aren't. So I know what order they came up in. Let's Poison Storm the right side. I can kill this guard as well, and that's probably the best strategic option right now. Alright, so this time I'll have Aurora fire off a cure. Because right now, probably the best thing to have is just a little bit of healing for everyone. I don't usually use Aurora's cure in the Magitek armor, but when I can't tell who's got what damage. Everyone's alive, good. No disasters, I guess. So I'll select Firebeam to torch the first dog. And then down to Revitalize, and now I've got to be careful on Aurora's turn because she's still on magic. So yeah, down to Revitalize, and down to Revitalize. This is just to conserve some minor resources, but I'll still take a hit before the battle ends, so pretty sure at any rate. So let's fire beam him. Yeah. I knew that was coming, but Aurora's still got cure to deal with that, so no issues. Okay. So skills, Aurora, magic, cure. Still got plenty of cure spells. They're pretty much free resources at this point because Aurora's not using your magic points for anything else, especially not in battle or anything, so. So yeah, now we've got the Prinnies, dude. I don't actually know what the Prinnies are a reference to. I feel like I probably should know, but it's just a game I haven't played, I guess. Writing up for a bit. This shouldn't take me to the Prinnies, unless I mess up. But I've already healed, so. So yeah, one step left, one step up. And now the Prinnies should be walking out. Alright, so now I gotta be careful again. That took a while. Okay, so here's the deal. Biggs and Wedge I can't tell apart, so it's hard to heal with them properly. So I'm going to use Revitalize 1-up with both of them, which means the guy at the bottom isn't gonna get healed. Heal you, and you're easy. Just fire off air rods, now that I know who's who. And thankfully everyone's order should be preserved in this case, because Aurora's slower than the two guards, and I don't care about the two guards, because they're doing the same thing. So I can just hold A right now, have the two guards heal themselves, so that Mr. Bottom Guy gets some healing. And have Aurora finish them off with air rods. That's the most efficient way of taking out this fight, because Poison Storm does no damage, and I don't want to use Fire Beam, obviously, that causes them to blow themselves up. I mean, I guess it's not obvious if you haven't played Return of the Dark Sorcerer before, but a Fire Beam equals they blow themselves up, so it's, yeah. Huh? I thought they were supposed to die after that, Air Rods. Whatever. It's not going to throw my strategy off at all. Just heal up this time, so that Aurora gets healing again. And Aurora should come up soon, hopefully. If she's not first, I don't care. There we go. Now that should be the end of them, right? Oh right, yeah, gotta tab through the messages. Just waiting there for a second. Skills, Aurora, magic, cure. Okay, so go all the way up. It's two lefts and all the way ups, and then two rights and all the way ups. However, the first one is kind of interrupted by the battle. Yeah, otherwise easy to recognize. And the good news is, unlike in vanilla, the music changes through here, which is pretty nice because it tells me exactly when I've entered the mines. So that helps me out a bit. I can just tab through this cutscene and everything's nice and easy peasy. There we go. So now I go up and left. Oh yeah. The battle seems to be kind of deterministic there, so it comes no matter what. Okay, this is Aurora. Not that it really mattered. Poison storm. I'm almost surprised an attack didn't make the rats immune to poison, or absorb poison, rather. It's because, I mean, it's kind of thematic for rats, and it would also give a reason to actually use the fire beam going through here, which there kind of isn't a reason to do. Bye. It's the end of that fight. I'll just keep going. There's probably no issues that cropped up after that fight. Gosh, I gotta be careful, I guess. If I take a step off, I could end up not reaching the save point properly. Maybe I should have thought about that earlier, instead of being a little bit uncautious. I also wasn't expecting a battle here, though. There wasn't a battle last time I did this. And I was expecting it to be the exact same, because the beginning of the game seems to do that a lot, but... Skills, Aurora, magic, cure. Alright, let's hope going up there was the correct choice. If it wasn't, I guess I'm gonna be a little bit lost, but I mean, it's within a small area, so it's not the biggest thing in the world. There we go. Alright, so, item. Save. First part done. Now I've just gotta beat the Fireweaver and the other stuff that comes after that. Okay, let's continue on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All the way up to the top. No battles would be helpful, I guess. Fireweaver is not going to be super easy. Oh, that's not good timing. I mean, it moves my cursor over to these, but those aren't useful for the boss fight, so... At least if all... It's just important that I have all three characters in the same place to make things a little bit more expedient, but... Wow, almost didn't notice that because I forgot it was the, that noise instead. Okay, so I'm in the cutscene. There we go. Now let's hope there's no battles before the Fireweaver because I'm going to, Skills, Aurora, Magic, Cure. Because right now I'm going to heal up, and I don't want to take damage again before the battle begins. Random Escross! Okay. I actually have to run back to the save point to save after this, because Tritoch is actually a threat this time, so... gotta be careful. Don't want to cram too much into this mini-segment here. Smash through the text at a reasonable pace so I don't accidentally select to ROTDS everything and mess myself up. Apparently he decided to move first, which isn't super good. because he used Blaze, and that's nasty. And I still haven't set up my Magitek Barrier, which I really have to do. Magitek Barrier is basically an absolute must for this fight. It is really nice to have around a 30% reduction to damage, basically for free. Since nothing cuts through defenses here, it's the first boss, that would just be rude. Okay, Rejuvenate should be to the left, which is good because I kind of need it. And obviously I can't do much this time around, so... So that should be all three characters rejuvenated, considering nobody's on slow yet. Everyone rejuvenate yourself again. Just menu trick here for a moment to buy myself a little bit of extra time. Unfortunately, unlike in vanilla, I have more Magitek Arbor commands, so it's a little bit harder to tell the characters apart. Alright, I'll let that fireball stick for the moment so that I can hit him with an extra couple ice beams. Ouch, that's not good. Hopefully nothing really bad happened. I'm only gonna hit him with one set of stuff per round, because any more than that gets really dangerous and dicey. Magitek Missile is my main source of damage. Weakness or no, this guy's magic defenses are high, so I definitely want to use the Magitek Missile here. And... Rejuvenate... yourself, I guess. Rejuvenate yourself. You rejuvenate yourself. There we go. So everyone should be pretty much at full right now. I think I'm in good shape for the moment. Okay. Let's have everyone rejuvenate themselves, not because of the damage, but because the slow's nasty. Thankfully, even Aurora was almost at her turn by that point, so if the slow affected her, it didn't affect her much. Okay, that's arguably better. The web shot does less damage, but that slow could be nasty, because it's really hard to tell a slow and dead soldier apart, so... soldiers should both come up first. That's not good. Hopefully the hits aren't racking up on one person or something. And then Magitek Missile for a follow-up. And now let's rejuvenate, because I kinda need it. Whoa, what? I don't recognize that attack. It never happened during my test run, so that's not good. I'm assuming it's Cave-In, but you never know with Return of the Dark Sorcerer, so... Don't let it throw me off, just rejuvenate everyone. Hopefully Aurora comes up. Yeah, I'm good. Ugh, he slipped in another attack. Well, hopefully Aurora uses a rejuvenate. There we go. I'll wait out this set of attacks, because he'll definitely get an attack in that I'll want to rejuvenate, so... I'll just wait here until he uses it, there we go. Selecting the character above, well, I guess it's kind of pointless right now because everyone's turns are lined up, but... By selecting the character above, I can potentially remove slow from another character, without having to wait for the slowed character's turn to come up, which takes a while. Wow, he actually beat Aurora there. I'm surprised. It's hard to tell whether a fireball hits everyone. Dang it, that's not good. Rejuvenate the two people above. This should be Aurora. I'll save her turn for the Magitek missiling. As it does way more damage than the soldiers' stuff. I think the soldiers are probably in okay condition right now, so let's have them attack as well. Magitek missile, his face. And I'm not just saying his face for no reason this time. That's actually starting to get nasty. If one of the soldiers has been dogpiled here, that could be bad. Maybe I should play it safe, but he's got some dangerous attacks that I don't, like Inferno, that I don't want to let him use that much, so... Uh-oh. Okay, one of the soldiers might be dead, actually. Which isn't good. It's really hard to tell them apart. It's possible he's also just on slow. Yeah, that's probably the soldier that I was waiting for. Yeah, okay, he was just on slow, which is fine. So I told the soldiers to... Yeah, it must have been the bottom soldier who was on slow, because he was the only one I didn't rejuvenate. Okay, that's the only way everything makes sense to me right now. It's the only theory that fits all the facts that I can think of. Downside is I don't know where Aurora is anymore, so I need to check manually now. Until I get everything sorted out. Just out of curiosity. Okay, so you're Aurora, so... Aurora's gonna come up first. I should really heal that fireball. I really don't like soldiers dying here. Or Aurora dying, which is also pretty bad, but actually not quite as bad. Even though Aurora's more useful. So, in normal circumstances, Aurora dying is the worst case scenario, but webshot missed, that works for me. Okay, I think that was a pretty lucky break at the end there, so I can just let loose on him. Soldier number three. Might even want to chance a second Magitek missile shot here. Because I know Aurora's not on slow right now. And she's the first to come up. So I can... Yeah, I'm gonna take the risk. And now, down to rejuvenate. Have them both rejuvenate the person to the top. Lots of damage off that round. I wasn't planning on doing any double Magitek missiles there, because it was a little bit worrying. Uh-oh. Hopefully that didn't go too badly. That's one rejuvenate. Uh-oh. I can't remember, did the other soldier use rejuvenate yet? Or did I even set him to do anything? I think I'm good. I think I'm fine. But if I skip one turn, it should be Aurora's turn again. Fireball. Or maybe I should just rejuvenate for another round. I think that might be a good policy. Because I think he might get another attack in. Oh gosh. At least Aurora will be rejuvenated. I don't know which order the turns are gonna come up in, so I've gotta be careful. Okay. I'm gonna wait for him to come out of his shell right now. This is Aurora. Okay, I'm hearing lots of physical attacks. It sounds a lot worse than it is. That move sounds like it's gonna do a lot of damage, but it's just like 30 to Aurora and less to the soldiers, so... Okay, Blaze, that's nasty. People probably aren't doing super well right now, but I don't think anyone's dead, probably. Okay, so I'm not sure who's gonna come up next. It's a soldier. Still out of his shell? I was expecting him to go away. Vitalize yourself. I don't think those parting shots are gonna make a difference, though. Heal yourself. Pretty sure everyone's still alive at this point, which is good. Definitely want everyone alive. Definitely keep the revitalized train up right now. And then maybe I can try to determine who's up first. Okay. Mr. Soldier Guy, let's just park your butt here for a moment. Okay, didn't use web shot again, which is good, I guess. Ice Beam. You're Aurora. Got him, okay. And I had a whole bunch of other damage coming out too, so if he hadn't died from that, he would have died from the next magic missile, I guess. So yeah, actually, pretty surprisingly interesting fight, considering it's literally the first boss. Wouldn't expect the first boss to do anything interesting, but there was quite a lot going on there. Down, left, left, down, left, left, down, left, left. This takes a while. There we go. Take this off. Okay, so how long did that take? 16 minutes. Actually not that bad, I guess. Probably because I got two shots in the one time. That saved a lot of time. Yeah, the last time on my test run, right at the end, he was just like, Inferno! Special attack, Elffire, the same soldier. I was just like, oh gosh, I hope that doesn't happen on the real run, but thankfully it didn't. Okay, let's take another go at Tritoch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All the way up to the top. Yeah, Tritoch is kinda scary because some of his attacks are pretty darn powerful even through my shell, so... And he attacks multiple times during a turn, which always makes things a lot harder. All the way to the right, which isn't very far. Move like a knight, or try to, and get a battle in one of the worst spots, but whatever. Might have been a preemptive though, in which case it's not that bad, I guess. So this is Biggs and Wedge's last hurrah, I guess, against Tritoch here. Okay, let's just finish walking before I try to heal. All the way up to the top. Because the enemies around here aren't likely to do a ton to me, so they're not gonna kill me or anything. Since they're intended for a single Aurora after all. So I just gotta make sure I've got HP when I go into the Tritoch fight. I got off to a really, really bad start last time, so hopefully that doesn't go so badly this time. Just pretty much nuked someone right off the bat, and it was just a disaster. Continue walking upwards. Another fight, wow. Didn't expect that, to be honest. I guess if Aurora makes it through this, it's free XP for me. Not that it's much, with the soldiers taking two-thirds of it, but I'm sure not killing them off when I need them for Tritoch, so Aurora's not gonna solo that bird. Continue walking upwards, even though I'm sure there's like no distance left at all at this point. Okay. Skills, Aurora Magic, Cure. Right one, and then I gotta go through this cutscene again. That should be enough walking, I think. There we go. Noises. Lots of power-ish noises coming from everywhere, and things freezing and burning and screaming and whatever. Hopefully this works on this attempt, because shouldn't be that bad, I guess. But everything was kind of a disaster last time, so it would be really nice if I could tell the soldiers apart, but because that way that would make it very easy to revive people, because I could revive and then rejuvenate on the same turn, but I just can't do that right now, so okay, it's an attack. It's kind of unfortunate that he preempts me. Put up your Magitek thing. Put up your Magitek thing. Let's buy some people some time. At least he didn't start out with Sonic Boom this time. That was part of what destroyed me last time. So yeah, whoever comes up next will probably be a soldier, I think. Actually, I shouldn't say that. I think Aurora's speed is about the same as theirs. So I can't really make the assumption that a soldier is going to come up first, but yeah, I need to poison storm right now. And the other two people should heal themselves. The opening is pretty nasty because I have to get a lot done at once. And rejuvenate, and then the last person should rejuvenate, and then I'm somewhat on my feet. And then I can continue spamming rejuvenate, because it's not really important for me to do anything until something bad goes wrong. Because for the moment, everyone's alive. Air blast, don't care. You're not gonna cut through my rejuvenate spam here. Problem is, I don't know who gets hit, so I can't save turns by waiting around with people, which would be very handy. Okay, just keep up the rejuvenate spam. So far, nothing going wrong like last time. Also, I need to keep in mind that if he does use bio, he immediately loses the poison status, which I didn't know last time, which is part of the reason why I had troubles. That's not an issue. That's just fireball, I think. Okay, second fireball. Might as well just use Inferno at that rate. Still, nothing that I need to really pay attention to with that. Goffman fires off so many attacks in... Okay. So many attacks in a turn that I do get some time to have my ATB recharge. So yeah, I gotta switch rows there. Kind of important because I don't want people in the front right now. Okay. Hopefully I get all three rejuvenates off. Hopefully Aurora didn't get hit by the physical attack earlier. Because she's left with single-digit HP, or close to it, after the third-tier spells. But it sounds like everything went okay, so I'll continue counting my blessings here. And nothing's happening, so I might as well... Okay, now stuff is happening. Just a standard turn, though. A single icicle spell multi-target isn't gonna do a whole lot. The biggest dangers are single target, third level spells, which might not be possible because I don't know how this boss is scripted. It may be scripted to automatically target the entire party by default with those. Haven't heard Rippler yet, which is good. I think he can skip Rippler sometimes. So, either that or he's just about to use it, probably, so. Air Blast again, don't care. Unless he uses Rippler, like, it's exponentially helpful if he uses Rippler very little, because if he's taking 2,000 damage a pop from Poison Storm, Poison Ticks there, he goes down pretty fast, but if I have to keep rebuilding it every single time, then things get a lot nastier. Even his second level spells aren't really that bad because they don't come close to killing me. Unless he single targets them on Aurora, but hopefully that doesn't happen. Oh, time to switch tactics and switch rows here. It seems like he skipped all the physical attacks he could have done in there, so that works for me. Because those physical attacks are not so nice when I'm in the front, and he combos them right after reverse polarity, which is kind of clever, I guess, but... Okay, that's Volcano. It shouldn't be killing anyone, though. And it's got such a long animation that everyone's got time to set up a Rejuvenate there, so... Yeah, as long as he... After all this time Poison has been doing damage, I'm fairly certain he won't get to cast Bio, so that's nice. Gotta be on top of that, because cutting my HP in half definitely sets up that character to die from something else. It's almost unfortunate that my last fight didn't go through, because that was a lot more exciting. I think. Yeah. There it goes. He didn't use Rippler once. I got about as lucky as I could have there. I just had to spam Rejuvenate the entire time. But last time, like, I was hanging on for ages with just one soldier, because... I basically just, like, only have time to revive someone to get immediately nuked by Red Nova or Volcano or Blizzard. And when that happened, it saved my life to revive the person because, this happened, like, three times in a row. But the problem was he wasn't poisoned because he used Bio. So I think that's the only reason why I died there. I think otherwise my third soldier would have kept on going and actually been able to almost solo the fight. Just reviving people to take third level spells for him. That would have been pretty cool, I think, but I guess I'll take the everything got super lucky fight as well, I guess. Also, I managed to revive Aurora right next to the start, but that was just before someone else got nuked due to bad luck, so... Sonic Boom, and then they didn't get a turn before he casted another spell on them, so... So yeah, let's talk to Arvis first off. Okay, I'm in the cutscene. Is Yeah, not much going on in this cutscene compared to the sound-heavy cutscene before Tritoch. Yeah, she's stuck with a capital letter at the end of her name, but due to the luck of the draw, her name at least isn't malformed there, so I guess that's one good thing for Aurora. So yeah, now I'm gonna have to menu trick. Yeah, yeah. You get it. I'm coming to the door, I'm in the washroom, you jerks! Almost done. There we go. All the way to the left. All the way to the top, which I can hear too. Okay, as I suspected, my memory cursor is not where it's supposed to be. It was on skills, that's right. Item, skills, equip. Equip, Aurora. Equip, right hand, iron sword. Not that it's gonna do anything for me in the next area. It's just not strong enough to be helpful. So grab that elixir from the clock, which I might use because, you know, I'm only doing the first bit of the game, so having an elixir at this point and no repercussions for using it is a bit of a bonus, I guess. So now let's go down and right until I hit the thing here. No battles in here, so I get no indication of anything really, but I could probably worm my way out of Arvis's house if you just plop me at a random spot, so it's not that big a deal, I guess. And I could run with the B button. Gotta take advantage of that. Okay, back to here. I have to say, I really like this song. I like it better than the original song for Narsh, so okay, I'm out of that. So, I want as few battles as possible in here, to be honest. Aurora's MP is stretched thin. The main problem with this area, everything has different elemental weaknesses, but the thing is, I can't tell the enemies apart very easily. The two enemies who I really want to tell apart the most, which are the rats that absorb ice, and the floating eyeball guys that are weak to it, and essentially, one can't be hurt by fire, and one can't be hurt by ice, which means I kind of have to go with the happy medium of shock for them, unless I can happen to identify a rat or one of those goblin guys. But the thing is, that depletes my MP twice as fast because I'm not hitting their weaknesses properly, and physical attacks are doing diddly squat almost, so I can't take advantage of those. And I guess I just realized I never thought to figure out where my spells were, but her magic, she doesn't have a lot of magic right now, shouldn't be too bad. All the way up to the top. Also, I'll grab that buckler, it's kind of helpful, to be honest. Left. Okay. No battles before I got the buckler, at least. Should be on equip, but I'm not going to take that chance. Skills, item, save. Item, skills, equip. Equip, Aurora, equip, left hand, buckler. Okay. Back two. Pretty sure that was on the second step. She's on the right side and she blocked an attack, that's nice. Okay, so pretty sure this is shock. So let's use that. If there's a goblin guy, hopefully he gives himself away, so that I can start using ice instead. Punch attack. How much I can glean from that. So this is probably double floater. Wait a second. Double floater or triple rats, and they attack three times, which means that I do have a way of telling them apart. Just the number of attacks. And the bite move, I guess. But that doesn't work if it's double floaters, because they don't have a bite move. Okay, so let's switch tactics to fireball here. I hope I don't mess this up. I'm starting to go crazy. What were the order of the spells here? This better not be Icyclar. I'm wasting all the damage I've done already. Yes, okay. My visual memory came through for me there, and now I'm hitting for double damage on them instead of single damage. These things are still pretty nasty, though. They're more dangerous than the other encounters in here. So identifying them quick is kind of important. Shock is still useful for the happy medium before I identify the encounter, though. Okay, so they're almost dead. Or they are all dead. Yep, they're almost dead. I had a feeling. These things never like to die together for some reason. So I can probably smack them with the iron sword. Hopefully there's only one. Did I luck out? Because that would be nice if I get to save a fireball spell. Skills, item, save. Skills, Aurora, magic, cure. One. I only want to use one because I want to try and save as much of my MP as possible. I'm totally willing to burn my lemonade because that won't come in handy ever again, but I just have to make sure that's enough. All the way to the top. Down. All the way to the left. I'm gonna have to take a step back here, even though I would mentally expect to have to do that, but. And all the way up to the top. Back two. All the way to the right. That doesn't tell me anything, it happened too quick. Okay. Let's see if I can identify this fight. Okay, there's probably a floater. So, let's make use of my third spell. It's probably double floaters, in fact. There's my icicles. And there's my two enemies. Yeah, I can tell by when I hit them as well, so I really should have thought of this sooner. But I guess I didn't save any turns by thinking of it when I did, so I didn't lose any turns, rather. This should be a relatively quick fight, because I'm hitting a weakness right off the bat here. This area, especially with the music, is just kind of pensive, because there's a lot of waiting between what I do, and I just have to make, like, one careful decision every now and then. Wait a sec. That was a bite noise. That's not good. Maybe I am fighting rats. Were there only two rats in the encounter? I swear I remember three. Maybe it's possible that the cloud guys, that the eyeball guys also have a special that. I don't want to fire off spells that waste turns. I'm just gonna continue with this. Maybe there are only two, and the extra thing was a counterattack, in which case this isn't going so well at all. I'm probably even going to need to drop a cure spell or something. to make it through the fight, but she also doesn't have much MP anymore. I don't really like this at all, but at least the next segment's short and I could theoretically make it through without a battle, so with enough restarts, no matter what, that lemonade will carry me through. This is what, the third fight or the second? I think it was the... Because that definitely has a huge impact on how much MP I have left. I think this is only the second fight, so... Thankfully, Cure heals a lot in comparison to what these guys actually do, so... Even if it takes forever to activate. Ugh, taking a lot of hits. I'm not blocking much. Should I drop another fireball? It might be risky. I kind of don't want to die and have to redo Tritoch again. I really hope I have enough for at least one more fireball cast. Yeah, I guess the formation in the mines earlier, when I had the Magitek armor, contained three of these guys. But I guess this formation contains only two. Okay, are they both dead or is it just one again? Okay, all the way right. There. Let's see what condition I'm in. 5 MP left. That's not a lot. I guess I should drop that lemonade then. Because I'm not going to make it through the rest of the mines without that. And I don't have any other use for it, considering I'm not doing an entire game. Okay, let's take another go at this. One down, all the way to the left. Back one, all the way to the top. Yeah, I already took a run at this, but I had two encounters by this point, so I was just like, forget it, I'm not even gonna continue. I don't even care. Left. I have to trigger this to get that merchant out of my way. Don't know how long this takes, so let's use the menu. Okay. I can hear that. Right and down. Best case scenario is only one battle. I can handle two quite comfortably. Three, that would be nasty, I think. Right and down until I reach the bottom. Up and left, right until I reach the switch. What? That doesn't sound like the switch. Did I happen to find a secret by mistake? There we go. Yeah, I must have found some sort of hidden secret somehow. I'll take it. No, I wasn't expecting that, and I still have no clue what it is exactly, but... All the way to the left. One, two. Okay, so that should bring me to the next area. And from here it's just left and up. No more fights with Aurora would be helpful, but apparently that's not gonna happen. Still, I can't complain about my luck so far. So let's use Shock, especially since that might have been preemptive, or at least I had a pretty full ATB when it started. So yeah, let's just go with my happy medium of Shock here, unless I hear something that'll prompt me to do something else. The issue is that I can't identify the double floater battle in any way, really. Okay, this is a double frost fur. So that means I can go and switch over to my fire spell. Which was here, I think. Ugh, I messed up. That was dumb. I already had that issue come up, so I should have known, I think, that what spell I was needing to use, but apparently not. But the good news is I'm in pretty good shape because at least I'll be hitting their weakness for the rest of the fight, so it'll at least be neutral. And I've still got about another fight's worth of MP left, so I'm not really in any difficulty. Five spells total is about 20 MP, plus a cure spell is 25, and I have 55 total. In fact, I could even drop two cure spells if I want to, realistically. Honestly, I should be like, only hit one with the first fireball spell. Okay, at least one of you's dead. Are you both dead? Okay, works for me. Yeah, I should technically focus fire one of them with the first fireball spell so that they die fast. The first one dies fast and it gets one less hit, but it's not that big a deal. Skills, Aurora, Magic, Cure. So yeah, I was probably somewhat close to dying there because I spent longer than I should have on that fight. But overall, not too big a deal. So let's continue left and upping, and hopefully I'll be able to make it without another encounter. The odds are pretty high, and I'm pretty sure I've already done it. There's that falling through the hole sound I wanted. So now I've got to wait a while for this cutscene to end, which is annoying, but it's not too bad, I guess. I've got the long flashback with Terra first and all the Empire stuff and trying some guards with overly powerful spells that don't do much coming from Aurora, honestly, by this point. And then we've got to sit through naming Cloud, which I can't see or anything, but at least I can name him properly. Then I've got to be on the ball for basically the last thing that I'm going to be doing in this little mini challenge here. Yeah, not quite as much going on in this cutscene in terms of sound because it's all in the flashback, so except for the short battle segment, they kind of just abstract any sounds away anyway. It's kind of quiet. Not that there was anything with just like soldiers marching and stuff like that, but I mean, I feel as if this wasn't a flashback, then you'd at least get some flashy noises when the slave crown goes on or something like that, but no, just pure quiet. Yeah, the vector music kind of covered both of these halves of the cutscene fairly well, but when it comes to the Return of the Dark Sorcerer music, the two tracks are a little bit more necessary, because that ominous music from before isn't quite fitting to this, and this isn't quite fitting to the previous cutscene. Lots of raising hands probably going on right now, raising and lowering hands, but time to fade out. And now we get to see Cloud coming in on his chocobo instead of just randomly showing up for some reason. It's especially kind of weird that Locke just kind of shows up the back door of Arvis's house. I mean, it's not that weird because it's imaginable that he'd end up going to the like back of the house to sneak in, but I mean, in terms of the gameplay, at least he'd have to go through the entire mine to get to Arvis that way. Kind of surprised you didn't use a Final Fantasy VII theme here, because like this seems pretty good, but like during Cloud's entrance, it just feels kind of strange not to have an actual FF7 theme in there. Okay, so still talking to Arvis because I haven't even named him yet. I think there's more lines of dialogue in Return of the Dark Sorcerer, so even cutscenes that are otherwise unchanged still. Wait, what? I thought he wasn't supposed to. Okay. Is there no naming screen there? Because I definitely did not press the start button. Yeah, I don't recognize some of the noises that are happening around here for some reason. Okay, so I guess there wasn't a naming screen, huh? Didn't see that one coming. I mean, I should have because I did a test run, but sometimes these things don't become noticeable till later. So, one, two, three. Shoot, was I out of the menu there? One, two, three. Okay, so I was in the skills menu, that's why things got thrown off. Okay. So anyway, back up to item. I want just this Moogle to go into the back row there. Because the most dangerous stuff is not physical in this fight, so I do want. So the extra damage is more important than the extra defenses against, like, their minor attacks, so. Okay. All the way down. Right. Down to. Right. Okay, switch to Mog. Let's take one step to the right. And. Okay, so I. Hopefully I did that correctly because I don't really have an indication. One. Two. Three. I don't want to exit the menu here like I normally do because I kind of have a timer here. So, Mog goes in the back and Minky goes in the back. So, yeah, the goal is Cloud takes out as many things as possible before he goes down inevitably. And then that's when Mog's team cleans up the rest and then hopefully goes for the kill. Actually, wait, I could put the other team in there. Okay, so pause just to think for a second. This person wants to attack. I heard a claw noise, so I want to attack the top to hit the Prinny. Everything's on point now. Cloud did an attack. No clue what it hit, unfortunately, so... And Miracle throws another wrench into things because it's random, so essentially, like, a lot of this comes down to I have no idea what's going on, but that's good because that was a cure 3, so everyone's doing fine for the moment. This is pretty chaotic, and the music doesn't help because it's a lot, like, more fast-paced and distracting than... Wow, something died? Somehow I didn't expect that. It's a lot more fast-paced and distracting than the regular FF6 battle theme, or Save Them. What was that? Okay. Nice, everyone should be back at full health now. That's a good way to end the fight, which will probably happen soon, I think. Soonish. Hopefully that finishes it. Or not. Maybe I just don't have a very good grasp of what's happening. Okay, that should be Cloud's team again. Hopefully everybody's where I think they are. Had to concentrate there, couldn't really talk. Wait, why did I move the cursor down? Oh, I want to attack to the left now. Because now the Prinnies are on the left side, and the guy that does the counterattacks is on the right. So I don't want to attack him. The problem is if a Prinny does go off, that's really bad news, because reviving is not a good, an easy thing to do at this point in the game. I've only got 2 recharges, and stealing is awkward, because steal and inverse sound the same. Wow, I swear those Prinnies are dying like a million times faster than I expect them to. I guess Cloud is just hitting everything on the ball, and I might have just mistakenly used the wrong attack there, but... Yeah, all I did was use full power, which probably won't amount to any... I'll eat my words on that one. So far, the actual battles are going nicely. Like, Cloud's team has been pulling through fairly decently, I think. No self-destructs and another battle. The navigation's the part that might shoot me in the foot if things go wrong, though. I should at least try to guess in a direction, because the Prinny's never out in front. Punch? Okay, it's probably left that I want to do. Dang it, I might have done full power again. On average, that's going to be less effective, I think, because I can't really use it properly. Because with full power, you generally want to wait around with Cloud's next turn and then set it up again as soon as it goes down. But I can't really do that when I can't see, so I can't really do it effectively, at least. But apparently he's using this patch here. Alright, hopefully the person who was berserked was not my healing Moogle, because I need my healing Moogle to actually be healing. If Cloud gets berserked, whatever, because he's still attacking. He's just less effective at it. I feel like things might be going wrong on my side. I haven't been hearing healing in a while, so... Could be some bad news here. Oh, there's still things. Still haven't heard of self-destruct, though. That's always a good sign. It's possible that my healing Moogle was just berserked, but even still, I'm probably in rough shape with that team. Okay, so... Alright. Yeah, I think I might just have two left. And that snowball's not gonna help either. So Cloud's probably just gonna die here. There's not much chance that they'll make it. Which means I'm relying on second team of Moogles now to hopefully carry me through. So, Snowball's a bad opening because everyone's at full HP right now. So, this person is... If this is the team I think it should be, this person is either Mimic or Healing. Which means I probably want to prioritize the healing. Or whatever Mimic Moogle's doing. Okay. Blizzard, which means this was a really bad opening, and it's this fight. Yeah, so I'm fighting with the team I think I'm fighting with, which is good, but this is probably my least effective team. At least I technically have two healers on this team, but... That's not likely to pan out, because it's really hard to focus my Mimic person on doing the right thing. Apparently they decided to do it there, though, which definitely feels nice to me, because... That means that my team's probably doing a lot better than they were 2 seconds ago after that snowball, blizzard combination. So yeah, but the problem is it's hard to actually deliberately put my party in this setup where I have extra healing like this. It's not something I can pull off reliably, I think, which means... And it doesn't help much against self-destruct, which is bad. So yeah, thinking about this carefully, I think I should probably have my Mimic Moogle... Just swing this time because I can't play around with self-destruct. There it goes. Which means that this team's probably not doing so well now either, but they'll definitely take out this fight. So that'll be four of the fights down. And Mog's team only has to deal with one of them. I mean two of them. But I really want that to go well because I need Mog's team in good condition. Now the other problem is how do I tell which team I'm actually using? The answer is I don't. Let's just have each team take one step to the right. Okay, so which team is this? Okay, so this is probably Healing Moogle. Okay, this is the same team I fought the last encounter with. Dang, I wasn't paying attention to the actual enemy attacks. This team has low chance of making it through, to be honest. I'll mimic the attack, which is okay, I guess. At least if the Prinus decide to blow up, they'll take their lives out with them, but that's still not much of a condolence, really. What is that attack, anyway? Well, at least everyone who's not the dead Moogle who was blown up last time will be at decent HP now. And now hopefully that, yes, one of the Prinus is dead. Oh no, wait, this might have been the other encounter, in which case I just killed a worthless enemy. Yeah, this is the other encounter, what am I doing? At least one of the enemies is down, even if it's not the Prinny. Uh-oh. My attacks seem to be coming slower now, so I might have another dead Moogle. Nope. It's just luck of the draw that happened, I guess. Okay, the Prinny's dead. So now it's just the dog, and he can't do a whole lot. Let's just hold A. See if we can keep this streak going with this team. And then see if I can actually somehow navigate Mog down to the Marshal, because that's gonna be tricky, when I don't even know which team is which, at this point. I have no idea which team I'm actually using right now when I press the Y button. Because the issue is, the battles really interfere with my ability to determine what's what. At least until they're gone, which is what'll happen soon. At least I know someone's in the way of Terra, or else this battle would have gotten through, so at least I might end this battle at full HP, well, with my three remaining Moogles, but if this is another double Prinny battle, that might not help. That's definitely the harder of the two. Okay, the last fight. Okay, healing Moogle. Okay, this is, okay, I'll be mimicking the healing, which isn't the best thing right now. This Moogle seems to have a flail, so he'd be better off in the back, but it's probably not worth the turn at this point. Okay, it's the good fight, so let's swap you to attacking the top Prinny. And then, okay, they're probably doing okay. This battle doesn't have that much damage output compared to the other one, because there's no frostbite, there's less self-destructs than snowballs, so. And I'm pretty sure they only use the rock throw attack when they're alone, so. Yeah, let's see. That Prinny's probably close to dying now. Oh, it just killed itself. I might survive with whoever he hit. Flail Moogle's alive. I think the boomerang noise might be my mimicking Moogle. Okay. Well, anyway, this battle is pretty much over. Wait, is the one at the back still alive? I don't remember if I ended up killing it. The good news is, if nothing else, Cloud is kind of out of the way, because he's lying on the floor behind Terra, so that's a plus. Okay, so all the battles are dead, so I have a moment to breathe, but where is everyone, and which party am I? Well, I can make sure I'm not, wait, I can figure this out, because I can equip Mog and Cloud, but I can't equip the top Moogle of the third party. And from there, I can determine which party is which. So... let's think this through. Let's save. Item. Just to make sure my cursor's at the top. Cancel out of the menu, which I can't hear anymore, which is annoying. Skills. Equip. Equip. Okay. So I am the miscellaneous Moogle party. So... let's just move these guys up to the top of the cavern right now. Press Y once. Now I should be the worthless Cloud party, who are all at 1 HP, so they're no good. And it doesn't matter if I learn Dusk Requiem, just for the record, because you get Wind Song, or its equivalent air guitar, without having to do anything for it. So, alright, so let's put the Moogles in the correct row, and that's the one I'm using for this next fight, so just for the record. So, I'm on equip, skills, item, save, wait, I don't care, left, top Moogle, that's putting Mog in the back, and, wait, you two were already in the correct row. Move back down, and I want to put you guys in the back, because this guy is almost all, attacking moves and not magic, or at least maybe not almost all, but he's more so, and than the encounters, and I want my healing to be as effective as relative to their attacks as possible, so. And now I just go down and right for a while. So yeah, I want all four characters in the back, even the physically attacking Moogles. Mog, of course, will still hit for max damage from the back, which is good. On my test run, I did this with Cloud's team, but I figure the overall principle should be fairly similar. In fact, easier, just because Mog's in the back and he's doing more damage than Cloud. He makes Cloud look like a schmuck for the moment. Although that's not going to stay the same way forever, or at least it wouldn't if I was playing a full game. At any rate, let's go left and down now. I miss the Marshal, which kind of sucks. Even if I am wrong about where I am at the moment, and I'm doing something stupid, I should hopefully be able to figure it out, because this area isn't too large, and lots of similar movements will do similar things, so... okay. That was a pain in the butt. Okay, this is Mog, so use your air blast. Okay, before these guys start attacking, I should try to get Mongoose to come out of inverse. Missed, I think. Steel doesn't do anything for me here. I don't need an assault helm for anything. Hopefully that was not my, healing Moogle, or I'll kill someone. Okay, good. Actually, it might have just missed. In which case, that's pretty lucky. I gotta keep an ear out for Mongoose, because I want to switch tactics when that shows up. but it's really helpful for getting rid of stop faster. Wow, one of them's already dead. Well, that's helpful, especially since it came in before Ice Rabbit. Dang, it's not working, is it? I think Mongoose is the rare, though, so it's only to be expected. Other than that, though, the fight's going really well, because one of the gags is dead, and... Oh, I think it got hit by Sonic Boom, that's why it died so quick. Still no Mongoose. Mongoose gets rid of Stop really quickly, and it's just helpful in general, because this team is not very fast. That's Air Blast, I think. Another one is dead. Yeah, this is way faster than with Cloud's team. Cloud's team, this is just so aggravatingly slow. I didn't die, though, even though I was using the exact same strategy. Nope. It's probably using that Slayer attack, though, so at least I'm getting some damage off from that, even though I'm completely wasting the Steel Moogle's turn. I just can't tell which Slayer is on because Sketch is weird. Oh yeah, and fun fact, dance moves sound like they're coming on the right side of the screens, so that's fun. No Mongoose. He's gonna have haste up in the next part and I won't, but the Skags will die a lot faster with Mog on the case than... So I should be able to hold out just fine, I think. I definitely would have died in... Oh, there we go. No. Wait, was... Yeah, that was me, I think. Sounds like it was on the right side. So, next turn I switch, okay, I really hope that wasn't Healing Moogle, but that isn't as quite as bad now as it was before. Okay, switch you to attack. You two are just acting in tandem, aren't you? Pizza, that's not gonna stop Mog for long. And I've got both my other Moogles on the case. Also, funnily enough, I'm still envisioning my healer Moogle at the bottom and my attacking Moogles in the middle two, even though I'm using a different team now, where the healing Moogle's in second place, but it's hard to shake when it doesn't make a difference in the end. So yeah, now I'm just gonna hold A. I want to attack the Skag in front at all times anyway, because I want to have a focused attack on one Skag when it comes out. Although I don't think there's any Skags out right now. I think Cloud was slightly faster at taking down the Marshall, probably because he's not wasting turns using Sonic Boom. But the Lado is... Two-handing that Lado is definitely stronger than either of the attacking Moogles on Cloud's team, so there's that as well. And Cloud can miss, which Mog can't, really. So that's the Mongoose on their team, which means that those Skags are out in full force again. However, that'll hopefully last a lot less time. And I had about the worst set of luck imaginable with Cloud's team at this point, and I still didn't quite die. I came very, very close, but he basically just used simple cure spells for healing, like quite a few turns in a row. And things were going pretty bad beyond that, except for the way the damage split, which was pretty even amongst everyone, so people weren't, like, dying, but... Wait, what? Can he still use Cockatrice? Is that the last move? If he hit the Marshall with that, though, it's probably worthless, and simple cure is bad. That's not helpful. You'd think Mog is less reliable damage than Cloud 2, but He's actually more reliable damage because Cloud can only hit one of the skags, and there's really only one I want to focus on. Whereas Mog can use Wind Slash sometimes, so. That's a lot of attacks on my side. Oh, that probably took care of just about everything. I mean, it's not quite a full heal because this Moogle's magic is 2, and that's literally just because the Diffusal Rod has 2 magic. That's the only reason why this Moogle has any magic whatsoever. The other Moogles... The other healing Moogles don't have magic. Any magic power at all. But they're slightly higher level, so they do about the same healing. Wait, was that only 3? Good, Wind Slash, that'll do a number on him. Still no dead ones though, eh? Gale Cut, that'll do a number on me. I really hope that another Skeg dies soon, because they've been getting longer than I want getting hits on me, so hopefully that's a Skeg and not hitting the Marshal. Oh yeah, that was the other thing about my test run. Cloud was just going AWOL on the Marshal at this point. He was like, I'm not attacking the Skegs, and then a couple times when he did attack the Skegs, he just missed. So it's like, what are you even doing, Cloud? But it's easier to comment on my test run, because I actually know what was happening on my test run, and I kind of don't know what's happening right now. Hopefully he hits the Skeg, but at least everyone's focusing on the one Skeg now. It's not my healing Moogle who was stopped. Okay, they are all alive. Good. I was mishearing it earlier. And this fight is basically over, because the Marshal on his own can't help much, even if Sonic Boom isn't doing a darn thing to him. Dang it, Mog. Oh well. If I had to choose a time for him to underperform, it's probably now, because the Marshal can't do enough damage to keep up with my healing without his Skegs around, so there we go, actual damage. I really hope that Natek didn't, like, make the Marshal absorb wind or something, because that would just be really annoying. Because I can't even see right now that he'd be absorbing it, but I doubt that's the case. Again, that's worthless. Might have been useful against the Skags, I don't really know. Might have just one-hit KO'd them or massive damaged them, but so yeah, this guy's days are numbered at this point, even though Cloud was slightly stronger for this. It's ironic, the Tritoch segment was the one I was expecting to be the easiest at first, and it turns out to be the only one that I actually incurred a death. All these other ones have gone really smoothly when I actually went for it, so though that was partly bad testing, because I would have probably beaten Tritoch anyways if I had known that you had to poison him again, but part of the reason why this guy takes so long is because he's also got some healing to go with his damage, so that really just delays the fight at this point. Yeah, because he just used a pizza, which takes out a bunch of my... What? How does that work? He uses a pizza and recovers 250, then I attack him one more time and he dies? Well, I don't get that, but not 100% sure what happened there. But either way, I beat the segment, basically. And I beat this little mini-challenge here. Just after this cutscene ends, I can reach the overworld, and then that's basically it for the... this part. But, true to form, I'll leave the blindfold on until this cutscene is over here. Okay, it doesn't take long to get out to the overworld from this point, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, the funny thing is, like, half the stuff I did during this mini-segment was basically improv'd. Because I never tested out anything. My original strategy involved Mog's team fighting four of the battles, but I didn't want to risk Prinny's blowing up on them when I realized how much more important Mog is to fight the Marshal, which is why I kind of invented everything else. And I was just like, ah, it'll probably work, and I never tested it, and I turned out to be correct about all that, so... Okay, made it to the overworld, so I can take this off now. Still not sure I'm quite done, but the blindfold's off at this point, so I just want to go show off the developer's house for people who haven't seen it. So, you're the music man. Yeah, of course I want a song. I think Jacquemus cycles through a few songs. Jacquemus is a pretty cool guy. He's got more than one song about up his sleeve. I didn't forget about Dre at all, I never knew who he was in the first place. Nice guy James being the only one that actually bothered healing me, thanks. I don't know, but I think he's a Pokemon master by now. Hello to you, Mads, too, Mads here. And we have Angelo over here. Which... that side quest is a little bit too far in the future for me, but 1800 gil, I'll take it. And pizza, yeah, I'm robbing your pizza in attack, hope you don't mind. Poco's somewhere down here. Cheat? How can you possibly think I'd cheat? I'd never cheat. I'm positively offended by that. Like, seriously, Poco Loco, how could you even think of saying such a thing? It's just, like, I felt like we were friends, like, and then you start doubting me and think I'm gonna cheat at this hack, that's just, ugh. Well, Natak, I hope you have a Merry Christmas. I know things have been busy for you this year, so, I hope you enjoyed the little present here, and I'll see you around on the forums.